ఇనీషియల్గా నేను ఏం చెప్తాను అంటున్నాను, స్టేర్ కేస్ డ్రా చేయాలంటే మనకి ఫ్లోర్కి ఫ్లోర్కి మధ్య దట్ డిఫరెన్స్ హైట్స్ బిట్వీన్ ద ఫ్లోర్స్ వీ షుడ్ నో దాట్. సో మనకి ఇచ్చిన ప్రాబ్లంలో అది 3300 అని ఇచ్చారు. సో ఫస్ట్ ఐ జస్ట్ వాంట్ టు డ్రా ఏ టూ ఫ్లోర్స్. వాట్ ఈస్ ద మీనింగ్ ఆఫ్ ది హైట్ బిట్వీన్ ద ఫ్లోర్స్? బాటమ్ ఫ్లోర్ అండ్ దిస్ వన్ ఈస్ టాప్ ఫ్లోర్. ఈ రెంటు మధ్య మనం స్టేర్ కేస్ డ్రా చేయబోతున్నాం. అంటే స్టేర్ కేస్ మనం ఇక్కడ టాప్ నుంచి తీసుకోవాలన్నమాట. ఇట్లా టాప్ నుంచి ఇలాగ వెళ్ళిపోయి అలాగే ఇలా అగైన్ దిస్ వన్ ఇక్కడ టాప్కి. దిస్ ఈజ్ అవర్ యాక్చువల్ మీనింగ్ ఆఫ్ ది స్టేర్ కేస్. అంటే టాప్ ఆఫ్ ది ఫ్లోర్ టు ది టాప్ ఆఫ్ ది ఫ్లోర్. ఈ వర్డ్ బాగా గుర్తుంచుకోవాలి. మీకు ఇచ్చిన మెజర్మెంటు 3300 ఏదైతే ఉందో అది ఇక్కడ టాప్ నుంచి ఈ పైన టాప్ నుంచి ఇక్కడ టాప్కి అన్నమాట, ఈ టాప్కి. సో ఈ రెండు ఇక్కడ ఉన్నటువంటి డిఫరెన్సే 3300 టాప్ టు టాప్, రైట్? సో దీన్ని బేస్ చేసుకొని మనం ఇప్పుడు డ్రా చేయబోతున్నాం. సో ఫర్ దిస్ వీ నీడ్ టు గివ్ సమ్ టూ లైన్స్ విచ్ ఆర్ అపార్ట్ ఫ్రమ్ ది 3300 డిస్టెన్స్. సో ఫర్ దట్ ఐఎమ్ జస్ట్ టేకింగ్ ఏ లైన్ ఆఫ్ రిక్వైర్డ్ లెంత్. లెట్ అస్ సే ఇట్ ఈస్ 8000. ఐఎమ్ టేకింగ్ అప్రాక్సిమేట్ లెంత్ ఆఫ్ ది 8000. సో ఐఎమ్ జస్ట్ గివింగ్ ద ఆఫ్సెట్. అంటే మీరు కూడా ప్యారలల్ లైన్ డ్రా చేస్తారు అంతే, అంతమించేది. సో ఎంత ఇవ్వాలి మనం? టాప్ టు టాప్ ఫ్లోర్ కాబట్టి 3300 నేను అది ఇస్తున్నాను అనమాట. సో దిస్ సైడ్ దిస్ ఈజ్ ద టాప్ టు టాప్. సో ఇక్కడ నుంచి మనం ఏం చేయాలి నెక్స్ట్? మధ్యలో మనకి ఇంకో ఫ్లైట్ ఉంటుందని మనం అర్థం చేసుకున్నాం. స్టేర్ కేస్ షుడ్ కంటిన్యూ టూ ఫ్లైట్స్. సో టూ ఫ్లైట్స్ ఉండాలి కాబట్టి మనకి ఈ మధ్యలో ఇంకొక లైన్ కావాలి ల్యాండింగ్ కోసం. సో దిస్ ఈజ్ ఫర్ ది ల్యాండింగ్ పర్పస్. సో ఐ నీడ్ ఎనదర్ లైన్ విచ్ ఈజ్ ఎట్ ఎ డిస్టెన్స్ ఆఫ్ 3300/2. సో అగైన్ ఐఎమ్ టేకింగ్ అన్ ఆఫ్ సెట్. నౌ ఆఫ్ సెట్ విల్ బి ద డిఫరెంట్ దట్ షుడ్ బి డిస్టెన్స్ షుడ్ బి 1650, రైట్? సో 1650 దట్ ఈస్ ద ఆఫ్. సో ఐ టేకింగ్ ది ఆఫ్ ఆఫ్ ద డిస్టెన్స్. నౌ ఐఎమ్ డ్రాయింగ్ ఎ లైన్ just joining the starting points, right? And now this is the middle point, that is 1650, right? And just refer your question in that they said that 150 is the rise. So now using the calculator, the total height divided by the each rise, that is 150. సో 3300 డివైడెడ్ బై 150 ఎంత వాల్యూ వస్తుంది? ఎనీ వన్? 3300 డివైడెడ్ బై 150 ఇట్ విల్ గివ్ యూ 22 నెంబర్, రైట్? సో ఐఎమ్ డివైడింగ్ దిస్ 3300 లైన్ డివైడెడ్ బై 150 ఇట్ విల్ గివ్స్ ది 22 పార్ట్స్. సో ఐఎమ్ యూజింగ్ ద రైజర్ 150. Therefore, 3300 divided by 150, it will give 22 parts of this.
22.
Right, 22. So, just using your scale or everything, just divide it in 22 parts by making it 150. So, 22, I am entered the number 22. So, here you are not getting any points, just I will show you. So it is already divided. So I am taking this one. Now you can see this line has been divided into 22 parts, right? So you can see this middle line 1650 is exactly matching with the division point. So now this is good. Now I just wanted to edit this its dimension. For this I required only landing, right? So just I am changing these properties. this total length need to be only 1000 because the landing width is given 1000. So just adjust it to 1000. So I am taking the line command, and then from this point set the rate 1650 0 comma 1650. So I require the 1000, therefore minus 1000 comma 0. So this is the landing. So in your problem he has mentioned that landing, where you after climbing 10 or 12 steps, you are coming at a position of the rest position, right? From that you are going to move another. So this is the landing dimension. So I provided this landing, right? So similarly I am just making this one in a different color to understood the difference between the landing and remaining portion. So I am making this one as a copy, or you can say this, I am removing this one, I just making a copy of this one. So this is the base point, right? So you just see what, why I removed that line means, from this point onwards I require the steps, that's why I am giving different line from this point after 1000, right? So earlier we are taking 8000, now I am taking 7000. I am just removing that 1000. So at the rate minus 7000 comma 0. So you understood the from the form a grid. So just take this one, just form a grid from this one, right? At the rate minus some approximate amount 6000 comma 0. Just similar all lines you have to draw from this point. It is easy procedure to form perfect dimension of the staircase. Even in the field condition also it is suitable for you, right? After that, it is the bottom yellow line represents the landing dimension, equivalent to the landing dimension. From after this point I am going to divide this line, right? So I need a measure of 250 because the tread is given 250. So hence you have to mention the tread dimension here. For this use the measure command, right? So I am just taking the measure command, and each length of the segment is 250, right? So 250 is your tread. I am removing that yellow part, that is landing. So 1000 I left over, and remaining portion I am giving that one, right? So I got the points of the after 1000, right? So each are 250. Now take the line command, form the grid from this point. Again just a CP. So for the drawing on the sheet, it is very easy to draw this all things. These are very in a line light pencil, that is 2H, right? I just given some 11 or 12 only, right? Approximate grid I had formed. Now from this point, it should be form a step that is includes rise and tread, So just give the rise and tread combination. So I am using now black color for this, or you can use the yellow. Yellow we will go for this, right? So use the line command, and this one is the rise, and again I am going for the tread. Rise, tread, 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 rise, tread. This one is rise and this one is tread, and finally we came here. So this is the last point. So for understood, this is the top of the floor where we reached. You know that the floor consists some base. Similarly, the staircase is also required some base. Hence, I am taking depth for this as a staircase foundation. I am giving a depth of 450 or 500 mm, whatever the required mentioned in the diagram, or as per the practice. As per the practice, right? I am just giving, right? And I am just skipping. So this line is not required for me now. I am removing this one, and remaining all is not required now. These are grid lines are now, it is not required. So you can remove all these grid lines now, right? And similarly, this line is these two. Now after grid formation, and you are formed step wise in a first flight. Now you need to generate the second flight. For this, you just do the same thing, extend all these grid lines to the top, and you take the horizontal grid lines here, right? Similarly, and then procedure from this point onwards, rise, tread, rise, tread, rise, tread, like that, you can reach here up to this point. So now for that point, I am just extending this one. So like this. So it is understood. After this point, you will get the slab like this here. So this is the top floor, your top portion. So I am taking yellow line from this point. So I just, it should be 1000. We know that landing should be 1000. Being it is a floor, it might be more than 2000 or 5000, whatever it may be. I am just to show, I am taking 1000. So now the floor is came here. Some line is missing. Now just take a mirror of this one. You can also use the select command of the fence also, but I am just for the accuracy, I am taking like this. So I am taking the mirror line from this point to this point, so it will be the similar way. It will touches the line which is I had drawn. So just follow the same procedure for the grid, right? So now we are not mentioned the in the question, what is the waste slab thickness? Now write down the waste slab thickness is 120 mm. The waste slab thickness is 120 mm, and landing slab thickness is 160 mm. So for this, we need to add the slab for the both landing and waste slab. So just use the slope for this to get the line of the step and riser. Just join two steps like this. Take this line. So this is the 120 thickness. Now remove this one. Now just extend this one up to the bottom portion. So this is the portion. Now just extend. So it will be extend. And same similarly, just take this landing one and just extend this one. Now it is given waist slab thickness of the flight, whereas I require the landing also. For this you need to take another line, which is 160. So I am just giving it 0, minus 160, and this is the intersection that you required for this 160. So just take a line. Landing thickness is, landing width is 1000. I am just approximately taking 800 to get the intersection. So this is the intersection point. So just trim it. And similarly, trim this one also. Now you got this, your landing portions. And your waist slab and landing slab. Now draw a line for the foundation of the stair. At the rate 0, minus 500. If it is not given in your book, the foundation, however, you need to draw this foundation. Without foundation, the staircase will not rest. Right? So follow the same procedure. Draw the line here. That is a parallel measurement in your drawing sheet. So take an offset 120. So I take an offset. Now use the extend command. So I am extending here. Now I am taking, this is the bottom. So I am taking this as the bottom. So I need to extend this one some more length. From this point, minus 1500, 0, approximate length I am just drawing. Now I will extend this one. This line, you can see this, the slab thickness of the, this is the another flight slab. This is the another flight slab. So this is the first flight slab and this one is second flight slab. So both will meet at a point. So for this, you just need a trimmed line, dotted line. So that you can understood in further also. That's why I am taking a changed line for this one. So from this point to this point, dotted line. From this point to this point, and this point to this point for your reference. So there will be a, you can see now. So this is the how the slab of the flights of the two different flights will be coincide, right? So this is the looking how it looks. So just remove this part. Now this slab definitely have some thickness, as we assumed that 160 is the slab thickness even for the land or the floor. Hence we need to take a land thickness or slab thickness. So just take a offset of 160 from this point to this point, you will get it. Then trim it. So this means here there is a floor like this, so you can have your room here. So that's why I'm not closing this one. Or if you want the, it is not the path, it is closing this side and you have corridor in the opposite direction, in that case you can close this one also, right? So this is the 1000 we are given for the entrance, let us say. Now you just extend all these things to the downward to get the plan elevation. So this is the plan, this is the plan, and this one is the staircase, how you are going to construct like this, right? So just do the same procedure for the remaining portion also. Take the lines from point to this point. Now just use the rectangle command. You can calculate this this total length. You just see here, this is the 1000, this thick is, this one is 1000. It is matching from this point to this point, right? So that means this one is 1000, right? 1000 plus how many treads are here? This is the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. These are the 10 treads, right? 10 into 250, that means 2500, right? So earlier it is 1000, this is the 1000, and this one is 2500, right? And this is also 1000. Total 1000 plus 250 into 10 plus 1000. That means 4500 is the total length. Therefore, we need to draw a rectangle. Of 4500 as the width, and each landing is 1000 width, so the other landing is also 1000. Therefore 1000 plus 1000, 2000. So in the plan direction, the other dimension is 2000. Therefore I am entering 2000 here. So this is my staircase room, you can say. Now just offset it, because the staircase has wall construction. So that offset is 230, right? So I just drawn the 230 line, wall thickness added outside, right? Just explode. After exploding, just try to start your projections from the staircase. So your first tread is from this point. So this is your point where the first riser starts. So just give the perpendicular line to this one and use the trim command. Just remove all those things, right? So this is the first line. Now total we are taking this, how many lines are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like that. So and the last line is this one. So just again draw this one from this point to perpendicular, up to this point, then trim it. So between these lines are coming, right? So similarly you can project all the lines. So you can see that this is the nothing but your tread width, that is 250 mm. So just simply copy this one. So before copying this one, I just want to do another thing. I just want a line at the middle of this one. So in order to have the two flights, I am just drawing a line here, in middle of here. And now I am taking another lines. Just I am drawing the same thing, but in different manner. So just I am taking a line of thickness, yellow line here. So this one is fully line. Now the other side is a hidden lines because they are in the upper side. So I am taking this one as hidden line. Simple. So I am taking it as a hidden line. So just similarly all the lines, just copy paste with an offset of 250 mm. So now I am changing the offset to 50. Take all those things here. It will match exactly the your landing. You can see this. This is matching, right? So this is how you need to draw the plan, right? So similarly, do the same thing for the upper flight also. So you reached the total flights. One is at the bottom and another one is at the top. Now you need to draw a door here. So for this you require the break. For that, just draw the line from this point to, or you can draw the rectangle and then deduct like that, whatever the case you can draw that, but this will be easy to understand. In from, I am just taking offset of 230, just drawing here and just offset. I am taking a door width of 1100, so I did the same thing here. Now you can use the break command. To this point. So this is my door position now, right? So similarly, I can draw the this arc for the door. Now after that you need to give the which type of material is your staircase and your brickwork. So just to show that one, I'm just closing this one. It's a irregular thing because the staircase might be continue, or if you want this would be with a different color of the brick masonry, that you can also take it as a brick masonry. I'm just giving the offset for this. 230 is our brick masonry, right? And similarly here also, I'm removing this line and also this line. Now I'm changing BD T type. If it is a continuous brickwork, if taken like this, and that means staircase is continuous for the two or three floors, the similar procedure will be taken place. Let us assuming that these lines are not required now. Now just hatch using your pencil or by using the CAD commands, or on the drawing sheet you should use the hatch command, right? This one. For the brickwork, I am selecting all the brick portions. Right. So now, just change the scale. So this is the brickwork, right? And here is some. It is not closer one. Now for the concrete, use the hatch. So this is how the staircase should be drawn on the drawing sheet also. The same procedure. You see how good it is showing like this. The concrete and the landing portion both are meted in well condition, and steps and riser are everything is clearly visible to you, and brickwork, right? So the plan of the staircase. Now you can also draw here some useful like this polyline for to show the where it is, how it is going to looking like.
also like this. So this is how approach, how you are coming, climbing the staircase. And from this point also, if you are mentioned here, there is a door in this as per in your plan. So you need to draw the door here, right? So hence just use the So this is your door.